Once the two panes are showing up on the tablet, let's modify our code to handle the list item click. On the phone, if an item is clicked in the forecast fragment, then we must launch the detail activity. On the tablet UI, once an item in the forecast fragment is clicked, we notify the main activity, which goes and replaces the detail fragment. The reason the two fragments don't talk to each other is because we want to maintain abstraction from each other. If the forecast list fragment started assuming that the detail fragment was always right next to it, then the assumption would break, for example on the phone, where the detail fragment is not inside the main activity. Therefore, a fragment must go through its activity, and the activity must know how to dispatch the event to the other fragments. Keep in mind that a fragment doesn't always have to be used in the same activity. In order for the forecast fragment to talk to the main activity, we should create a callback interface. It's a better assumption to say that the fragment will always be within an activity that implements this callback than to say that the forecast fragment will always be inside the main activity. The detail fragment is a good example of how a fragment can be used in two different activities, the main activity and the detail activity. So don't rely on getActivity returning a specific activity class. Using the gist that we provided, use the callback class to notify the activity that a list item has been selected. See the hint below on the item click listener. Then the activity can either launch the detail activity or replace the detail fragment based on whether it's a phone or tablet. When you work on this task, you'll run into an issue of how to pass the selected item's URI to the detail fragment. Now your instinct might say to create a custom constructor where you can pass in the date. However, we don't normally create custom fragment constructors. If you ever rotate the device, for example, the system can't call your custom fragment constructor with the right parameters. However, it can use the empty fragment constructor and initialize it with the same bundle of arguments you used earlier. So to pass information to initialize a fragment, create a bundle of key value pairs and then set that as the arguments on the fragment. Don't confuse this arguments bundle with the saved instance state bundle. Once a fragment has been initialized, you can't change the arguments. You can only read from them, as seen here. On the other hand, the saved state bundle is for storing information once a fragment has been running, and you can populate it in the onSaveInstanceState method. The bundle can preserve state across orientation changes, or if the fragment or activity gets killed by the system. That's why you receive it back again in the onCreate or onCreateView methods. Once the detail fragment starts being displayed on the tablet, we need to make sure that it doesn't get out of date if the location changes. If the user went to settings and entered in a new location, when they come back to the main activity in the onResume method, we should detect that the location has changed. We do this by comparing the mLocation string with the location that's stored in shared preferences. If there's a difference, then we find the forecast fragment and notify that the location has changed. Similarly, we find the detail fragment and notify that the location has changed. Since the detail fragment is a dynamically added fragment, we need to make sure we find the right instance in the fragment manager. We do this by calling findFragmentByTag and passing in this tag. We associated this tag with this fragment when we first did the fragment transaction to add it to the screen. If you didn't already create a tag and associate it with the detail fragment in the fragment transaction, then go ahead and do it now in the onCreate method of the main activity. And you'll notice that the detail fragment tag is just declared as a string at the top of the file. After we make the changes to the main activity, we go over to the detail fragment. We add a new method, onLocationChanged, that takes in a new location string. First, we try to figure out what is the date for the data that we're currently showing. Then we create a new URI with the new location as well as the date that we're already displaying. We update the mURI and then we restart the loader. See the instructor notes for the code related to handling the location change. This is what the app should look like when you're done. When you tap on a different date, it updates the detail pane. You can remove any hard-coded data because the layout should be populated dynamically now.